Good Thursday morning. Colossians chapter 4. Epaphras, a member of your own fellowship and a servant of Christ Jesus, sends you his greetings. He always prays earnestly for you, asking God to make you strong and perfect, fully confident that you are following the whole will of God. So here's a question. What does working hard look like to you? Is it sweating in the gym? Is it tackling, cleaning your attic that you've talked about doing for years? Is it moving a friend into their new house? Mowing an acre of grass? When we think about hard work, we often think about blood, sweat, and tears. We rarely think about the kind of hard work Paul describes here at the end of Colossians. Colossians 4:12 describes Epaphras wrestling in prayer for his friends back home. He struggles consistently for his friends to be strong in their faith. Epaphras was a hard worker, and one way he demonstrated that was through his prayer. Prayer doesn't have to be our first defense. It can also be our first line of attack. Epaphras' love for Christ compelled him to go on the offensive, praying that his brothers and his sisters would love Jesus more and more and stand firm in their faith. Note what Epaphras does not pray for. He's not asking for their problems to come to an end. Often, when hard times comes our way, we ask God to take those things away. And there's nothing wrong with wanting to see cancer healed or broken hearts mended or a wayward child to come home. But Epaphras reminds us that God, take it away, isn't the only way to pray for someone who's struggling. Instead, he's asking that they may grow into mature, confident believers, people whose faith is stronger for having been tested. Epaphras reminds us that maturity is a precious gift, more valuable than a life of ease. Lord, as I pray for my friends today, I ask that you help them to continue steadfastly in your will. Help them, Lord, to pray proactively for their friends and family, as I pray for them. In your holy name I pray. Amen. God bless you. I'll see you tomorrow.